live, I think. I never know until you click that chat. Faux show. That was way off beat. What's going on? Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. I'm going to finish up mixing this dark R&B track we created some days ago, maybe a week ago. And I have the music video finally done for the video. So, did I say that right? No, for the song. I have the music video finally done for the song. So now what I need to do is go back and mix the song, maybe re-record one part of it, because at the end, I would freestyle the whole song. But at the end, it's kind of like, I don't know, I made up kind of like a mumble-ish kind of word, which is fine. But I might change those two words out or just cut it out and add some kind of special effect or something. So I'm going to show you how to mix R&B compared to, firstly, let me make sure I'm live. That would probably be a good thing. We are live. We have three folks in here. Thank you to all three folks. Yes. Okay, what up, Info? First one to like the video. Appreciate that, Info. Thank you. Thank you, dude. AJ, I don't know if you're still here, but shout out to you. All right, so I'm going to move very quick. This is my real workflow. And again, at the end, I'll play it through. But at the end, there's like a couple words that I just kind of made up. Like four on the dot. I don't even know what I'm saying right here. Now we pop. Afro Lord, what's up? I feel bubbly. Like right at this point, two in the waist, but four on the throne. It sounds like four in the throne, but it doesn't make any sense. So what I'm gonna do is chop that part out. Wait, now we pop it. I feel bubbly. Alright, that's good. But I'm gonna get rid of that part. I forget the ending. Yeah, and the ending doesn't make sense. So I could either let the music play and kind of fade out, which is possible. It's only what, 2-4 bars? Give me. Cause they love me. What up, Abdul Mumin? I'm saying that way wrong. I could just let the beat ride out. Let's do that. Let the beat ride. Just kind of fade it out. So I want to create a fade, so let's go to our master. So I got to move very, very fast because I got to mix this song so I can send it back to my video producer who's going to put the song back into the music video he made and then export the good, high-quality mix. Okay, so my workflow so far was we made the song together live stream. Let me say my hellos before I just go on my rant. What up, Ernest? Deuce. Amin Hussein. What's up, Isaiah? SS Fame. Blessing sent from the Midwest. Awesome, man. I always wondered who lived in the middle of the United States. Cinemailer. What's up? Red Beats. Activate. What's up, Sketch? So we live streamed how to make this track. I think it was Friday the 13th. Yeah, because the video is called Friday the 13th. How to make R&B or dark R&B. That's where this track was made. Now I'm going to go back and mix it because my video producer came up with the music video. So what I did was I made the song with you. I sent it off to my video producer to make a video around the sketch of the song. So he needs the time length of the song and he needed the vibe and like certain keywords of the song so he can get a vibe. So he sent me the full music video back. So the music video, another music video is done. But now I have to go back and make sure the song actually sounds good and makes sense. So this shows you the back and forth between all this stuff. And you can edit stuff. There's still room to edit. Conflict. Just email us. Right now we have a support team. Just email support@busyworksbeats.com. Can you please make a tutorial on how to make the audio sound more professional? Yeah, we're going to do that right now. Meaning like making it not sound too roomy. Roomy is just your microphone. So my microphone's going to pick up the room because my room's not treated. So it's going to pick up all the reverb off the walls. That's something that is based on your environment. Maybe we'll do something on acoustic treatment. But again, if you're going to spend that much money, it's probably more cost efficient to go to a real studio and just save yourself the headache. If you're going to be shouting into your microphone, I mean. What up, Horizon? Lord Mills is back. I missed so many of your live streams. Reason being, I'm overseas. Awesome, man. Where you at? Where you at? Geronimo. So I'm going to move extremely fast here. The only thing that didn't load up for me was the channel strip because I didn't realize I was using a demo version the whole time of UAD's SSL 4000E channel strip. So I'm going to copy the settings from that channel strip to the legacy version. It's the same thing, basically. I just got to copy the knobs. So that's probably the most boring part of what you're going to see. So the vocal can sound like it does in our other tutorial. Other than that, what I need to do is turn stuff down, I think.
like a bad luck. Yeah.
Wait, let me see.
It's true.
So we're hitting at about,
I don't know what to do.
-6. Gives us enough headroom, but the 808 pulls it up to -3. So I might pull the tracks down a little bit just to give it a little more room for the mastering. And what else do we need to do? This track doesn't need to hit super hard. It's not supposed to punch like a Rick Ross trap anthem. It's just not that type of track. So every song is not about punchy, super aggressive bass all the time. And what else do I need to do? And, oh, I need to change the pads to 445. That's the note I told you about before. When you go back and forth with Omnisphere, you have to set the tuning back to its thing, because it was at 440 before. It was at 445 when we made this track, but then I made another track with Omnisphere and I changed it back to 440 tuning. So I have to make sure that pad is back to 445. So we left a note here that says 445 tuning. And I just got to make sure all the instruments are 445. That's something that you can easily overlook without even knowing. So now the pad sound a little more in tune. So again, I'm going to turn off my mic because I have to use my monitors here. Oh, you're good. You don't have to. I just wanted to be fair and just show you the behind the scenes process. I'm not going to be too talkative on this one. So let me start moving forward. So those are the main objectives. Again, I'm going to copy the settings from one channel strip to the next. I'm going to turn stuff down as a whole, and then I'm going to work on the mastering to make it a little bit louder, but not like insanely loud, like a Travis Scott song. Yeah, I'm starting to like all the new songs I'm putting out. Now I'm like, oh, I need another music video. So I'll decide if I like put that to a music video, but we have music video in the stash. The visuals for it, so we can always apply it to a music video. I'll see. Thank you, though. Is that you want to mix referencing your mono once you have all the stereo stuff mapped out, mix in mono so you can see, because some stuff sounds really good in stereo, but you don't realize what it sounds like in mono. So what I'm going to do now is pull this mono, and certain things like stereo instruments, like the pad, if it's super stereoized, then it needs to have, you know, a body in the middle or the center so people can hear it on things like Instagram, for example, which converts your stuff to mono. So I'm going to go to the mono and solo each thing to make sure it's heard in mono. So that's what I'm going to do right here. And that's another tip, I guess. And let's do that.
I'm feeling looser. baby, I got the juice. Yeah, baby, I got the juice like you. You told me we're cool, we're through. Now it's like I'm in a noose. Now I'm all over the news. Can't get through this dude. All I wanted was you. You and me. Police are calling and telling that's all the Bacardi, yeah. You and me. Naughty Bacardis and bodies and bodies, yeah. Bacardi's got bodies, bodies, bodies. Yeah. I know the one time. We did it one time. Shouts to the one time. All for the one time. I never faded. You were jaded. I'm your favorite. Now you hate me, cause they love me. Now we poppin', I feel bubbly, yeah.
I feel a loser. Is it bad luck? Is it bad luck? Is it bad luck?
You told me we're cool, we're through. Now
it's like I'm in a noose. Now I'm all over the news. I'm feeling looser. Is it bad luck? Is it bad luck? Is it bad luck? I don't know what to do with you. Is it bad luck? Is it bad luck? Is it bad luck? Yeah. I know I do. Yeah, we do. I know I'm cool. Yeah, we go. Is it bad luck? Is it bad luck? Is it? I don't know what to do with you. My heart loose, got proof. Baby, I got the juice. Yeah. Baby, I got the juice. Like you. You told me we're cool.
We're through.
Now it's like I'm in a noose. Now I'm all over the news. Can't get through this dude. All I wanted was you, you and me. Bali is a Cali, Dali, that's Ali Bacardi, yeah. You and me. Dali Bacardi's and bodies and bodies. I know the one time, we did it one time. Shouts to the one time, all for the one time. I never faded, you were jaded. I done waited, I'm your favorite. Now you hate me, cause they love me. Now we popping, I feel bubbly. Is it bad luck? Is it bad luck?
All right, so I'm satisfied with that mix. Again, the main kind of trick to this mix or master is this Waves S1. So what it's doing is pulling the stuff further and further apart in the stereo field to where it feels like the middle is a separate thing. And that's what's going to make your mono feel like it's more impactful. So I highly recommend this plugin. I used to think that I could achieve the sound with other plugins, but this plugin is definitely my new go-to for my master track on my stereo bus. Just simply pulling it up a little bit in width so that all the stereo stuff is like 10 feet away from the mono stuff, and it creates this nice little stage or gap in the sound. Excuse me. So that's all I was going to do. I'm going to export it now and wrap it up. But hopefully you learned something. I just wanted to at least show you the process. I didn't want to just do it by myself and not show you. So that's how I really mix. That's how I really master. And that is it. So I'm going to wrap this live stream up. Again, sorry if I didn't answer your questions. I was trying to type certain questions. Selling beats? Just pick one, really. It's no specific one. Some people like BeatStar, some people like the other ones. Video. Could we get a video where you do a song from start to end? Maybe like the thing where all the starters could start? Yeah, we do. That's what we do on our... If you just type in 808s and Mermaids, BusyWorks Beats, it'll pull up a lot of live streams where we built these songs from scratch. Like this song that we just worked on, we built that live together on a live stream. So that one's called Friday the 13th, and it was something about R&B. So Friday the 13th, we did this song. Some ideas for how to turn a marching band vibe into a trap beat. You'd be surprised how many people are not going to watch half those ideas that we come up with. It's hit or miss, but I appreciate you. How to make a guitar into trap, how to turn a marching band vibe into a trap, how to make... Island vibe beat more modern. Okay, I'll look into those ideas, but again, everything's hit or miss nowadays. But I'm gonna wrap this up because I don't want it to have a long tail to it. Yeah, it's gonna be the official project is gonna be available on Spotify and all that. Spotify, Tidal, Apple Music, etc., etc. All right, yeah, the website busyworksbeats.com is definitely where we teach you how to do that complex stuff, because you're asking can you layer an 808 over like a bass element. There's a way to do it, but you have to use mid side information or mono stereo information, or you could do it through EQing and filtering, or you could do it through side chaining or ducking the sound. So it gets complex. That's why I said it gets more complex. And the other question was what was your other question? I forgot. Then I'll wrap it up. You said LFOs. Not LFOs. Can you use compressors on 808s to make them pop? Yeah, compressors are actually something people don't apply to 808s because they think you don't need them. So there's a lot to mixing. I would highly suggest going to busyworksbeats.com because it's more of a fundamental thing, you know? And then once you understand the fundamentals, you understand how that applies to an 808. And the 808 was from the Ultimate Kit, from the producerkit.com, Trizza. Made that sound with Diego Av and the Ultimate Kit, and I used it here. And I think it's where I got the kicks from too. Yeah, I did. All right, so wrap it up. Oh, you'll see me and Triz have a video where we're on the Razor Blade Pro. You'll see that video. It's really cool. We were at Patchwork Studios in Atlanta and we made a beat together. Pause. But it's cool. You'll see it soon. Will be. All right, so I gotta wrap it up. Thanks for watching. It's BusyWorks Beats. Oh, the video pros. Whatever. It's cool. All right, BusyWorksBeats.com.